How's it going, everyone? All right. So my name's Carson Hay. I'm from the North Coast region. I'm a freshman. I'm from Annalee High School.
All right, what's going on, everyone? I'm Logan Tosta. I'm from the Central region. And I'm from the Elk Grove chapter. All right, so today we're gonna be showing you guys what kendama is. Kendama is an ancient Japanese skill toy. It consists of a ken, a string, and a ball that's called the tama. So the ken has three cups and a spike. Carson here, he's gonna show you guys the most basic tricks of kendama. So the first trick is called a big cup. These tricks aren't easy, give it up for him.
Let's go.
All right, so this next one he's gonna do is called a small cup.
Let's go.
Give it up for him. All right, this other one's called a base cup. This last one is a little bit tricky, it's called a spike. Let's go. All right, so now Carson's gonna give you guys some freestyle. He's gonna show you guys what you can do. Let's go, Carson. Yup. All right, Carson, he's been playing for 2 years now. It's his first time on stage, so everyone, cheer him on. All right, so what's cool with kendama is everyone starts in the same shoes, you know? We all gotta learn new tricks. We all start in the same spot. The more we practice, the better we get. All right, let's go, Carson. Yeah. Oh, let's go. Yup. Ooh.
All right, guys. This is Logan Tosta. He's been doing kendama for 6 years. He's sponsored by Kendama USA. He's showing you a little creativity you can do with kendama. It's all in your imagination. All right, guys, let's cheer Logan on. Kendama has brought Logan all across the world. He's gone to Japan twice. He's gone to Minnesota, he's gone to Atlanta. He's gotten top 10 in the world. All right, he's gonna do a trick called border balance. Oh, and he got it. All right, you ready? All right, that was the art of kendama. My name's Carson, Kendama Carson on Instagram. This is Logan Tosta.
Make sure to follow us on Instagram. Logan Tosta and Carson_Kendama. Thank you, guys.
Hello, California FFA. Can we restart that? Hi, my name is Catherine Kukolka, and I'm representing the Rio Linda FFA chapter.
On his way home from Candletop, been 2 weeks gone and he thought he'd stop at Webb's and have him a drink before he went on to her. Andy Wolo said hello, he said hi, what's doing? Whoa, said sit down, I got some bad news, it's gonna hurt. Said I'm your best friend and you know that's right, but your young bride ain't home tonight. Since she been gone, she been seeing that Amos boy Seth. Now he got mad and he saw red. And he said, boy, don't you lose your head, cause I tell you the truth, I've been with him myself. was the night that the lights went out in Georgia. That's the night that they hung an innocent man. Well, don't trust your soul to no backwoods southern lawyer, 'cause the judge in the town's got bloodstains on his hands. Well, Andy got scared and left the bar, walking on home 'cause he didn't live far, you see. And he didn't have many friends, and he just lost him one. Brother thought his wife must have left town, so he went home and finally found the only thing that he left him, and that was a gun. So he went off to Andy's house, slipping through the backwoods, quiet as a mouse. Came up on some tracks too small for Andy to make. He looked through the screen at the back post door, and he saw Andy lying on the floor in a puddle of blood, and he started to shake. The Georgia patrol wasn't making the rounds, so he fired a shot just to flag him down. A big belly sheriff grabbed his gun and said, "Why'd you do it?" Judge said, "Get on a make-believe trial." Slapped the sheriff on the back with a smile. Said, "Supper's waiting at home and I gotta get to it." That's the night that the lights went out in Georgia. That's the night that they hung an innocent man. Well, don't trust your soul to no backwoods southern lawyer, 'cause the judge in the town's got bloodstains on his hands. They hung my brother before I could say the tracks he saw while on his way to Andy's house and back that night were mine. And his cheating wife had never left town. That's one body that'll never be found. You see, a little sister don't miss when she aims her gun. That's the night that the lights went out in Georgia. That's the night that they hung an innocent man. Well, don't trust your soul to no backwoods southern lawyer, 'cause the judge in the town's got bloodstains on his hands. That's the night that the lights went out in Georgia. That's the night that they hung an man. Well, don't trust your soul to no backwoods southern lawyer, 'cause the judge in the town's got bloodstains on his hands. Thank you.
Here we go. Woo! You know what time it is? Just believe. Woo! Let's go. It's a new era in agriculture that we're living. Future farmers got a vision, coming at you with pride and purpose, and a willingness to live in service. California FFA, putting all the motive in to motivate, ability to see in a brand new way. We stand for tomorrow, we stand for today.
It's time to grow, plant a seed. If you know how to dream, you got all that you need. If you believe, time to grow, plant a seed. If you know how to dream, you got all that you need. If you believe,
beyond belief in agricultural education, build a belief and foundation with a mission to accelerate. With the California FFA, expectations, career success, determination, never second best. The possibilities are infinite, we're confident.
Time to grow, plant a seed. If you know how to dream, you got all that you need. If you believe, time to grow, plant a seed. Plant a seed if you know.
you need if you believe. Time to grow, plant a seed.
You know what time it is.
I didn't want you around. Those pretty faces always make you stand out in a crowd. But someone picked you from the bunch. One glance was all it took. Now it's much too late for me to take a second look.
Vice President! president, Kyler Vernon! And your state FFA president, Matt Rosa!
The arena will come to order. We are now holding the fifth general session of the 91st Annual California FFA State Leadership Conference. Mr. Vice President, are all officers at their stations?
I shall call the roll of officers, determine if they're at their stations, and report back to you, Mr. President. The Sentinel.
Stationed by the door.
Your duties there?
Through this door pass many friends of the FFA. It is my duty to see that the door is open to our friends at all times and that they are welcome. I care for the meeting room and paraphernalia. I strive to keep the room comfortable and assist the president in maintaining order.
The reporter.
The reporter is stationed by the flag.
Why by the flag?
As the flag covers the United States of America, so I strive to inform the people, in order that every man, woman, and child may know, the FFA is a national organization that reaches from the state of Alaska to the Virgin Islands, and from the state of Maine to Hawaii.
The treasurer.
Stationed at the Emblem of Washington.
Your duties there?
I keep a record of receipts and disbursements, just as Washington kept his farm accounts, carefully and accurately. I encourage thrift among the members and strive to build up our financial standing through savings and investments. George Washington was better able to serve his country because he was financially independent.
The secretary.
Stationed by the ear of corn.
Your duties there?
I keep an accurate record of all meetings and correspond with other secretaries wherever corn is grown and FFA members meet.
The advisor.
Here by the owl.
Why stationed by the owl?
The owl is a time-honored emblem of knowledge and wisdom. Being older than the rest of you, I'm asked to advise you from time to time as the need arises. I hope that my advice shall always be based on true knowledge and ripen with wisdom. Mr. Vice President, why do you keep the plow at your station?
The plow is a symbol of labor and tillage of the soil. Without labor, neither knowledge nor wisdom can accomplish much. My duties require me to assist at all times in directing the work of our organization. I preside over meetings in the absence of our president, whose place is beneath the rising sun.
Why is the president so stationed?
The rising sun is a token of a new era in agriculture. If we will follow the leadership of our president, we shall be led out of the darkness of selfishness and into the glorious sunlight of brotherhood and cooperation. Mr. President, all officers are at their stations.
Thank you, Mr. Vice President. The Secretary will call the roll of members.
From the Central Region!
With 154 members, the Central Region's the center of the hype.
The Southern Region!
The Southern Region has 116 delegates present who know it's always leadership season!
The North Coast Region!
The North Coast Region has 70 delegates from over 35 chapters ready to delegate it.
The San Joaquin Region!
The mighty Maine San Joaquin is proud to announce that we have 146 delegates who are ready to believe.
The Superior Region!
Four chapters, 108 committed delegates, because we said we would. We are the Superior Region, and, oh yes, we are superior by far!
The South Coast Region!
The South Coast is ready to post up and vote with 70 delegates.
I am pleased to announce at this, the fifth general session of the 91st California State FFA Leadership Conference, there are 620 delegates and 6,998 members and guests present, Mr. President!
Thank you. FFA members, why are we here?
To practice brotherhood,
honor agricultural opportunities and responsibilities,
and develop those qualities of leadership which FFA members should possess.
May we accomplish our purposes. I now declare this, the fifth general session of the 2019 California FFA State Leadership Conference, duly opened for the transaction of business or attention to any matters which may properly be presented. If there's anything that you should know about this next individual, it's that he believes there's only enough time left in this world for good food, good friends, and fine classic cars. California FFA, join me in welcoming to the stage my co-chair for this session and your state FFA Vice President, Mr. Kyler Vernon.
He gets up before the dawn, packs a lunch and a thermos full of coffee. It's another day in the dusty haze. Those burning rays are wearing down him.
So much for that whole taking pictures thing, huh?
Yeah, we're not too good at it. But I was thinking, you know, this year we've been blessed with a wonderful team dynamic. That being four guys on the officer team.
That's right, Kyler. It's been a great year with lots of funny moments.
And at the end of the day, it's just guys being dudes.
And dudes being guys.
And so, even though it's just guys being dudes.
And dudes being guys.
We thought it'd be awesome if we highlighted some of the best times where it's just us guys being dudes.
All right, here's the first one.
Okay. So,
the first day that we moved into the state officer house, we had to lay down the law.
Yep.
That is, Saturdays are for the boys.
That's right. That's right. Isn't today Saturday?
Yes, it is.
You know what that means. It's time to whip out our sign. Saturdays are for the boys.
We're just gonna leave that right there.
Now, that concludes our very first session of just us guys being dudes.
And just being guys.
But we are about to begin the fifth session here at the State FFA Leadership Conference. In this session, we'll recognize our State FFA Scholarship, National Chapter, and Star Reporter competitions.
We will also experience the power of believing in agriculture by recognizing our outstanding proficiency winners. And don't forget, we'll be hearing the retiring address of our very own State FFA Secretary, Ms. Alexius Wolf.
Throughout this session, we will
believe in agriculture.
I know it rains or it pours. I know I was born to be yours.
The National FFA Organization and California Agricultural Education, including the Foundation and Association, award over $2.1 million annually to student members.
Our first scholarship is the Ammon Board of California Scholarship. The Ammon Board of California is an agricultural promotion group to help people better understand various types of marketing orders. Their funds are used for marketing and research programs in the almond industry. Two students will receive $1,000 scholarships, three students will receive $2,500 scholarships, three students will receive $5,000 scholarships, and one student will win the $7,500 scholarship. The scholarship finalists are Kayla Zalesny from the Napomo FFA chapter. Ashley Porter from the Livermore FFA chapter. Cameron Kemper from the Dixon FFA chapter. Alexis Lupton, Galt Liberty Ranch FFA. Melinda Lowe, Orland FFA. Mason Justice from the Aetna FFA chapter. Nicole Motoizo from the Gustine FFA chapter. Shelby Stillman from the Merced Golden Valley FFA. And Micah Ortiz from the Galt FFA chapter. The two $1,000 scholarships go to Cameron Kemper. And Shelby Stillman. The three $2,500 scholarships go to Mason Justice. Ashley Porter. Kayla Zalesny. The three $5,000 scholarships go to Melinda Lowe. Alexis Lupton. And Micah Ortiz. And the $7,500 scholarship goes to Nicole Motoizo!
Let's give all of our scholarship winners for this round one more round of applause.
Fraternity was founded in 1904 and has long since embraced the future of agriculture. For over 100 years, members have strived for an academic excellence as well as professionalism through service to achieve our overarching goal to create a broader, better agriculture industry. AGR guides students to make strong career decisions through fellowship and philanthropy. The finalists are David Lopez from Holtville FFA. Blake Morgan, Oakdale FFA. And Dylan Basilla, O'Neill's Minarets FFA. The winner of the $1,000 Alpha Gamma Rho Scholarship is David Lopez. Next up is a Jerry L. Biggs Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship, sponsored by the California FFA, is given in memory of the longtime San Joaquin Region Supervisor, Jerry L. Biggs. The finalists are Alyssa Humphreys, Merced Golden Valley FFA. Jody Perolini, Turlock FFA. And Alexis Batista, St. Helena FFA. The winner of the $1,000 Jerry L. Biggs Memorial Scholarship is Alyssa Humphreys. This year, the California FFA Foundation hosted a new fundraising event in an effort to keep up with membership growth and needs, the Blue Corduroy Classic. The Blue Corduroy Classic focused on alumni and highlighted their roots in agriculture, their entrepreneurial spirits, and for some, the successes they've achieved that all started with their SAE. The Blue Corduroy Classic Scholarship is a result of this event and intended to honor a student who possesses the similar qualities of many of our alumni. The finalists are Michael Resendez from the Old Niels Minarets chapter. Ashley Pike, Tracy Delta Charter FFA. And Malia Arpon, Fullerton Sunny Hills FFA. The winner of the $1,000 Blue Corduroy Classic Scholarship is Malia Arpon. Scholarship is the Jerry T. Davis Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is sponsored by the California FFA and honors Mr. Davis for his outstanding service to the California Association as the Assistant State FFA Advisor. The finalists are Bobby Marchi, Turlock FFA, Lindsay Swall, Tulare FFA, and Brittany Thompson, Galt Liberty Ranch FFA. The winner of the $1,000 Jerry T. Davis Memorial Scholarship is Bobby Marchi. The Paul Freitas Memorial Scholarship is next. The Paul Freitas Scholarship recognizes the outstanding commitment, determination, and leadership traits found in Paul Freitas. The finalists are Caitlin Linderholm, O'Neill's Minarets FFA, William Claflin, Redlands Grove FFA, and Carolyn Boaster, Turlock Pittman FFA. The winner of the $750 Paul Freitas Memorial Scholarship is Caitlin Linderholm. The next scholarship area of the evening is the Mabel W. Jacks Scholarship. Miss Jacks left a trust that continues to support scholarships each year for deserving FFA members. For the Mabel Jacks Scholarship, the finalists are Olivia Hanna, Aetna FFA, Dax Souza, Tulare FFA, Grace Jardin, Exeter FFA, Bailey Ruiz, Santa Maria Pioneer Valley, and Michelle Borges, Oakdale FFA. The three $1,000 Mabel W. Jacks Scholarship recipients are Michelle Borges, and Bailey Ruiz. Brian J. McMahon is a past state FFA advisor for the California FFA Association. The next scholarship, sponsored by the California FFA, is named in his honor. The finalists are Alexa Chantel Serrano, Escondido FFA. Natalie Anselmo, O'Neill's Minarets FFA. And Lindsay Mendonca, Tulare FFA. The winner of the $1,000 Brian McMahon Scholarship is Lindsay Mendonca. The next scholarship is a Dorothy McMillan Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is in the name of a longtime friend and supporter of the California FFA and is sponsored by her son, Mr. Dick McMillan. The finalists are Jocelyn Juarez, Wasco FFA. Daniel Van Ryan, Morgan Hill Sobrado FFA. And Savannah Souza, Hollister San Benito FFA. The recipient of the $1,000 Dorothy McMillan Memorial Scholarship is Savannah Souza. The next scholarship is the Dean McNeely Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is in the name of a longtime friend and supporter of the California FFA. Dean McNeely served California FFA as a high school ag teacher, Modesto Junior College professor, and he retired as the Dean of Vocational Education from Delta Community College. The finalists are Gilberto Ortega Moraz, Madera FFA. Presley Hewitt, East Nicholas FFA. And Cole Marchi, Turlock FFA. The recipient of the $1,000 Dean McNeely Scholarship is Gilberto Ortega Moraz. My Job Depends on Ag is a social media grassroots effort to show how many people's lives are related, connected, and most importantly, dependent on agriculture. Their goal is to illustrate just how massive the fraternity of agriculture really is, as well as educate and inform the public with articles, stories, and images, and more directly from the farmers, ranchers, and other agricultural support businesses whose daily lives and livelihoods are affected every day by agriculture in this country. The finalists are McKenna Feaster, Elk Grove FFA. Sushi Rosas, Mountain Empire FFA. Ashley Sorensen, Reed Lee Emanuel FFA. And Janie Champin, Rippin FFA. The two recipients of the $500 My Job Depends on Ag Scholarship are McKenna Feaster. And Sushi Rosas.
We are now going to take a pause in our scholarship awarding and welcome up to the stage our very own state FFA talent.
Hello, my name is Daniel Rodriguez and I'm from Granite Hills, San Joaquin Valley. Before I start, I want to say one thing. My songs aren't sweet, but I'm going to dedicate this dance to my grandpa that's watching from heaven.
In a world where nothing is certain, only music can help you to find the right way. The way you should follow today.
Guess who's back? Still doing that shit, Andre?
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
Check me out.
You're a jerk.
I know.
You're a jerk.
I know.
You're a jerk.
I know.
You're a jerk. You're a jerk.
No
boy. You're a jerk. You're a jerk.
No boy.
You're a jerk. You're a jerk.
No boy.
You're a jerk. Jerk. Jerk.
Jerk.
Let's hear it one more time for our state FFA talent!
The next scholarship is a Jamie Lynn Petty Memorial Scholarship. Jamie Lynn Petty was an active member of the Bloomington FFA chapter, participating in livestock projects, livestock judging, Harley Pro, and leadership, holding offices both in her Bloomington chapter and the citrus section. She was dedicated to all that the FFA had to offer. These scholarships are given in her memory and honor for all the lives that she touched and continues to touch by helping students achieve their educational goals. The Jamie Lynn Petty Memorial Scholarship funds award scholarships annually in the Southern region and statewide. The Southern region finalists are William Claflin. Anna Grulowski. Sarah Grizzle. And Issei Soto. The $500 scholarship goes to William Claflin. The $750 scholarship goes to Sarah Grizzle. The $1,000 scholarship goes to Anna Grulowski. And the $2,000 scholarship goes to Issei Soto. The finalists in the statewide scholarship program are Kylie Farmer Chowchilla, Sierra Shoemaker Selma, and Josh Hoyple, Merced Golden Valley. $1,000 scholarships will be awarded to each of the two runner-ups, and the $1,500 scholarship goes to Josh Hoyple. The Past State Officer Scholarship is being sponsored by the 1992 to 1993 California State FFA Officer Team. Members of the team include President Kevin Porter, Paso Robles, Vice President Devery Bauer, Gonzalez, Secretary Matthew Terra, Newman Aristimba, Treasurer Travis Hagen, Chico, Reporter Stephanie Wilmeth, Kingsburg, and Sentinel Jed Murray, Lindsay. The scholarship was developed to recognize students with outstanding participation in agriculture, leadership, and education. The finalists are Garrett Alford, O'Neill's Minarets FFA. Caitlin Dins, Bakersfield Frontier FFA. Lauren Erickson, San Luis Obispo FFA. And Tanner Hoekstra, Ripon Christian FFA. The two $1,500 scholarship recipients are Caitlin Dins. And Tanner Hoekstra. Universal Technical Institute, Inc. is a provider of technical education training for students seeking careers in entry-level automotive, diesel, collision repair, motorcycle, and marine technicians. The California FFA Foundation has partnered with the Universal Technical Institute to provide a $10,000 scholarship to FFA members who are choosing to go to a technical school after high school. The Universal Technical Institute scholarship recipient is Daniel Perez Garcia! The Willie Family Scholarship is sponsored by the Willie family. The Willie family farms rice and almonds in Nicholas, California. Their sons went through the FFA program and they wanted to help FFA members take advantage of opportunities that FFA offers. The finalists are Daniel Aristegui, Elk Grove FFA. Carolina Lemus, Santa Maria Rigetti FFA. Grace Vertigal, Oakdale FFA. And Madeline Holmes, Fortuna FFA. The two Willie Family 1,500 scholarship recipients are Danielle Aristegui. And Grace Vertigal. The final scholarship of the evening is the Zenith Insurance Company Agricultural Safety Scholarship. For more than 60 years, Zenith Insurance Company, Zenith, has built a reputation as an industry leader by providing superior customer service with a strong focus on the agricultural industry. Specializing in workers' compensation, Zenith writes business in 46 states and the District of Columbia through full-service regional offices. Building on their extensive agricultural experience, Zenith's Agribusiness Solutions Division was introduced in 2010 and provides property, liability, auto, and umbrella insurance for California agricultural farms and businesses. The finalists are Drew Vogt, Reedley Emanuel FFA. Sarah Grizzle from the Hopeful FFA chapter. Elizabeth Watkins, Central Catholic FFA. And Hannah Mancibo from the Chowchilla FFA chapter. The two runners-up will receive a $2,000 scholarship, and the two 3,000 state-winning scholarship recipients are Elizabeth Watkins. And Drew Vogt.
Let's give all of our scholarship finalists one big round of applause.
You know, Matt, I got to thinking. And even though it's just us guys being dudes.
And dudes being guys.
The girls sometimes can be just as much guys as the guys can be dudes. So we thought it would be a disservice to Devin and Alexius if we also didn't too consider them dudes.
Yes, those girls indeed can be just as much dudes as the dudes can be guys. You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying. But Part of being a reliable dude is knowing how to cook.
This is true.
Oh, boy.
And I hate to say this, but the girls, they can't cook.
No.
I mean, it's so bad, man. We pray after the meal.
I mean, I tell you what, the girls' cooking is so bad, the flies pitch in money for Febreze, okay? Tell you what.
Man, that cook is so bad. Up until this year, I didn't know that meatloaf could glow in the dark.
But Matt, all things aside, do you know who can cook it up and bring the heat?
Who's that, my dude?
Our next state FFA talent!
Hi, California FFA. So my name is Maddie Riston, and I'm from the O'Neill's Minarets FFA chapter in the San Joaquin region. Today, I'll be singing "I'll Always Remember Us This Way." That Arizona sky burning in your eyes. You look at me and babe, I wanna catch up on fire. It's buried in my soul like California gold. You found the light in me that I couldn't find. So when I'm all choked up and I can't find the words, every time we say goodbye, baby, it hurts. When the sun goes down and the band won't play, I'll always remember us this way. Lovers in the night, poets trying to rhyme. We don't know how to rhyme, but damn, we try. But all I really know, you're where I wanna go. The part of me that's you will never die. So when I'm all choked up and I can't find the words, every time we say goodbye, baby, it hurts. When the sun goes down and the band won't play, I'll always remember us this way. The whole world fades, I'll always remember us this way. Ooh. Thank you.
Once again, put your hands together for our state FFA talent. Supervised agriculture experiences allow students to become involved in the foundation of FFA, that being agriculture. Proficiency finalists recognize those students who have gone above and beyond in their supervised agriculture experience projects. Students who are awarded the state proficiency may have the opportunity to compete and represent California FFA at the National FFA Convention and Expo. Please put your hands together as we welcome to the stage our state proficiency finalists.
The first proficiency area is agricultural communications. The state sponsor is Vivaic Incorporated. The three finalists are Lauren Francis of the Livingston FFA, Ariel Schulten, Sebastopol FFA, and Amy Marquez, Sunny Hills FFA. And your state winner is Ariel Schulten. Ariel is a freshman at Oklahoma State University, double majoring in agricultural communications and agribusiness. Ariel worked for Farm Trails in advertising and event management for agritourism and for her college's PR committee with online communications. Ariel plans to return to California after graduation and work for an ag business in communications or youth development and ag literacy. Congratulations, Ariel. In agricultural education, the state sponsor is CEV. The finalists are Michelle Borges, Houston FFA, Marissa Pendleton, Sebastopol FFA, and Yesenia Tellez, Buena Park FFA. And the state winner is Yesenia Tellez. Yesenia is a senior at Buena Park High School, where she assists with the management of the Buena Park FFA chapter. Yesenia's responsibilities include training the station leaders, writing curriculum and developing new activities for the tours offered, and coordinating the agriculture education offerings at the local Boys and Girls Club. Yesenia will be attending Chico State University in the fall, majoring in agriculture education. Congratulations, Yesenia! The Agriculture Mechanics Design and Fabrication Award is sponsored by Ponderosa Telephone Company. The finalists are Josh Hoipel, Merced Golden Valley FFA, Ari Prince, Tulare FFA, and Alonzo Portillo, Santa Maria FFA. And the state winner is Josh Hoipel. Josh Hoipel is a senior at Golden Valley High School. Since his early years, Josh has spent an immense amount of time constructing and building farm equipment for the family business and other local farmers. Josh has been able to construct multiple large projects, including shank rippers and an innovative orchard soil conditioner, which is used in many walnut and almond operations. Josh plans on attending Fresno State to major in agriculture education or agriculture engineering, and one day become an agriculture educator or engineer for an agriculture equipment company. Congratulations, Josh! Agricultural mechanics repair and maintenance entrepreneurship is our next area. The state sponsor is Far West Equipment Dealers Association. The finalists are Cody Parker from Merced FFA, Austin Helms, Bakersfield Highland FFA. And Tyler Schmeich, Paso Robles FFA. And the state winner is Cody Parker. Cody is currently attending Merced College after graduating from Merced High School. For the past 4 years, Cody has worked to grow his business. He repairs and maintains trucks, tractors, and other large equipment. Cody is investing in his future as he plans to earn a diesel mechanic certification from Merced College. Congratulations, Cody! Agricultural mechanics repair and maintenance placement is our next area. The state sponsor is the Ammon Board of California. The finalists are Victor Becerra from Livingston FFA. Mark Doss, Napomo FFA. And Jacob Knox, La Habra FFA. And the state winner is Victor Becerra. Victor is a senior at Livingston High School. For the past 4 years, Victor has worked in the shop at Becerra Trucking Repairing and doing basic maintenance on their trucks and trailers. Victor is planning on investing his earnings from his job to pursue a career in agriculture business. Congratulations, Victor. Agricultural processing is sponsored by Blue Diamond Growers at the state level. The finalists are Austin Ashwand and Turlock Christian FFA. Aiden Smith, Bear River FFA. And Seth Hilfiger, Holtville FFA. And the state winner is Austin Ashwanden. Austin is a junior at Turlock Christian High School. Since he was 12, he has worked for the families Ammon Scheller, Skitten, Ammon Training, forklift drivers, troubleshooting problems with equipment, and running the floor of the Scheller. Austin is planning on taking over the family business after his dad retires and looks forward to the day he solves the other Scheller problems faster than his dad. Congratulations, Austin! In the area of agricultural sales entrepreneurship, the state sponsor is the California Association of Pest Control Advisors. The finalists are Alyssa Loretto from Merced FFA. Preston Balls, Reedley Emanuel FFA. And Haley Hoffman, Dixon FFA. And your state winner is Preston Falls. Preston was an active member of Emanuel FFA and is currently pursuing a degree in agricultural business at Reedley College. For over 5 years, Preston has owned and operated his fruit stand business, Top Fruit. Preston will continue his business in the future and pursue a career as a fruit sales broker. Congratulations, Preston. Agricultural sales placement is our next proficiency award area. The state sponsor is in memory of Carl Bacon and Sandy Harris. The finalists are Ireland Best, the Merced Golden Valley FFA. Brooklyn Young, Kingsburg FFA. And Kylie Anderson, Sebastopol FFA. And our state winner is Kylie Anderson. Kylie is a sophomore at Annalee High School. For the past 4 years, Kylie has worked for her family's business, Leading Edge Supplements and Supplies and Shag Swag, doing everything from inventory to interacting with customers and performing demonstrations. Kylie's planning on using the knowledge and earnings she's acquired from this job to become a large animal veterinarian and take over leading edge when she's older. Congratulations! California Association of Pest Control Advisors is a state sponsor for the Agricultural Service Proficiency. The finalists are Darren Borba from the Christine Chapter, Gloria Becerra from the Ridley Middle College Chapter, and Jace Earhart from the Sutter FFA Chapter. And the state winner is Darren Borba. Darren Borba from Gustine, California is a graduate of Gustine FFA. Darren has worked for Larry Borba Custom Hay Hauling for the past 5 years, hauling big and little bales of hay for hay growers all over Merced and Stanislaus County. Darren is planning on finishing college and would eventually like to take over his dad's business and expanded it with custom cutting, raking, hauling, and trucking business. Congratulations! AgriScience Research Animal Systems is the next proficiency award and is sponsored by the California Beef Cattle Improvement Association. The finalists are Elizabeth Veter from Elk Grove FFA, Grace Jardin, Exeter FFA, and Riley Diarchy of Marysville FFA. And the state winner is Riley Diarchy. Riley is a sophomore at Marysville High School. Riley performed an agriscience research project comparing two different quality feeds on market hogs. She hopes to attend the University of Wyoming and major in ag business with future plans of using her research to operate a commercial hog operation. Congratulations, Riley! AgriScience Research Integrated Systems is our next proficiency area and is sponsored by Valent USA. The finalists are Atticus Humphrey from Sanger FFA, Sam Norgrove from the Healdsburg FFA Chapter, and Emma Thorpe, El Capitan FFA. And the state winner is Atticus Humphrey. Atticus Humphrey is a plant science major at the California State University of Fresno. Atticus is currently working on a plant genetic study at the Jordan Agricultural Research Lab at FSU. He plans to continue in the area of agricultural scientific research and will be pursuing his undergraduate degree at Fresno State University. Congratulations, Atticus! The next proficiency award is AgriScience Research Plant Systems and is sponsored by Tasteful Selections. Our finalists include Mackenzie Camacho from O'Neill's Minarets FFA, Jake Mendez, St. Helena FFA, and Dean Hill, Templeton FFA. And the state winner is Mackenzie Camacho. Mackenzie Camacho is a junior at Minarets High School. For the past 3 years, she has worked on finding and controlling the spreading of bacteria and fungus in crops and trees, including discovering the most effective fungicide towards preventing in the growth and spreading of certain diseases and funguses in California's walnut trees. Mackenzie is planning on furthering her career in the STEM field by pursuing a career in engineering. Congratulations! Beef Production Entrepreneurship is sponsored by the California Cattlemen's Association. Our finalists include Austin Thompson, Clovis East FFA, Bailey Morrell, Willows FFA, and and Jenna Fields, Morgan Hill Soprano FFA. And the state winner is Bailey Morrell. Bailey is a freshman at Colorado State University and a graduate of Willows High School. Bailey is the owner and operator of BSM Show Cattle, breeding, raising, and marketing seed stock Hereford cattle. Upon graduation from Colorado State University, she will attend law school and plans to pursue a career in agricultural law. Congratulations, Bailey! Livewire Production Products Incorporated is a sponsor of the Beef Production Placement Proficiency Award. The three lucky finalists are Emily Wise, Bakersfield Christian FFA. Kate Grimsman, Hamilton City FFA. And Adrian Garcia Romo from Salinas Everett Alvarez FFA. The state winner goes to Emily Wise. Emily is a sophomore at Bakersfield Christian High School. For the past 2 years, Emily has been working for Red House Beef in their Angus breeding and grass-fed cattle operations. She assists with artificial insemination, vaccinating, pasture care, and the farm store. Emily plans to either attend Texas A&M or Clemson University, majoring in animal science to pursue a degree or a career in beef production. Congratulations, Emily!
Please help me in welcoming to the stage your next state FFA talent!
I've been thinking, I want you to be happier. I want you to be happier. When the morning comes and we see what we've become, in the cold light of day, we're a flame in the wind, not the fire that we begun. Every argument, every word we can't take back, 'cause with all that has happened, I think that we both know the way that the story ends.
thoughts. Found the image of you being with someone else while it's eating up inside. But we ran our course, we pretended we're okay. Now if we jump together, at least we can swim far away from the wreck we made. Then only for a minute, I want to change my mind. Cause this just don't feel right to me.
Once again, let's put our hands together for that wonderful state FFA talent.
Associated Feed is a state sponsor of the Dairy Production Entrepreneurship Proficiency. The finalists are Billy Marchi, Turlock FFA. Haley Fernandez, Tulare FFA. And Samantha Gambinini, Petaluma FFA. And your state winner is Billy Marchi. Billy Marchi is a junior from Turlock FFA. For the past 3 years, Billy has maintained 27 head of dairy cattle and competed at several shows at the local, state, and national levels. Billy is planning to invest his project by researching genomic testing and continuing to raise high-quality dairy cattle. Congratulations, Billy!
Good job, Billy!
In dairy production placement, the state sponsor is Connor AgriScience. The finalists are Jobani Ventura, Layton FFA. Jacob Lepore, Sebastopol FFA. And Jared Poldervat, Hamilton City FFA. And now our state winner is Jacob Lepore. Jacob Lepore is a senior student at the Sebastopol FFA. His SAE consists of working at Lepore Dairy in Valleyford, California. At the dairy, he manages feeding calves, rotating pasture, and general animal husbandry practices. After graduation, Jake plans on attending Santa Rosa Junior College, then transfer to Chico State to major in agriculture business. His ultimate plan is to own his own herd of cattle and run his own business. Congratulations! Diversified Agriculture Production is sponsored by Cultivating Change Foundation. The finalists are Jared Campos, Merced FFA. John Mark Vanderpool, Tulare FFA. And Cole Dixheimer, El Capitan FFA. And the state winner is John Mark Vanderpool. John Mark Vanderpool works for Circle V Dairies in the Tulare High School farm. At Circle V Dairy, John Mark works with dairy operations and farms pistachios and almond trees. At the Tulare High School farm, John Mark helps to manage the dairy facilities and farm alfalfa and winter forage crops. Congratulations! Yes! Diversified Crop Entrepreneurship is sponsored by the Ammon Board of California. The finalists are Cole Marchi, Turlock FFA. Eric Velasquez, Santa Maria Rigetti FFA. And Jasmine Hooford of Escondido FFA. The state winner is Cole Marchi. Cole Marchi is from the Turlock FFA chapter. For the past 4 years, Cole has farmed 18 acres of double crop rotation, including corn and oats that he will sell for dairy cattle feed. Cole plans to attend Modesto Junior College to earn an associate's degree in ag business, then transfer to a 4-year university. Congratulations, Cole! CSU Chico College of Agriculture is a state sponsor of the Diversified Crop Placement Award area. The three finalists are Guillermo Ruiz, Mendota FFA. Ty Cota from Gridley FFA. And Edwin Madrid from Buena Park FFA. The state winner is Ty Cota. Ty Cota is a graduated senior at Gridley High School. Ty's SAE takes place at Thikinson Farms in eastern North Dakota, where he helps oversee the daily operation of a multi-grain production farm. Ty currently attends North Dakota State College of Science, where he majors in precision ag. Ty hopes to one day become a part owner in the family operation. Congratulations! In the diversified horticulture area, the state sponsor is Crop Science, a division of Bayer. The finalists are Savannah Downs, Bakersfield Christian FFA. Raylan King from Hollister FFA. And Karina Gutierrez from Fallbrook FFA. Our winner is Savannah Downs. Savannah is a sophomore at Bakersfield Christian High School. For the past 2 years, Savannah has grown and managed her plant science SAE projects, including a cut flower garden, vegetable garden, houseplant and succulent nursery operation, and floral design business. She sells her produce at local farmers markets as well. Savannah plans to use her knowledge and earnings from these projects to pursue a career in plant sciences. Congratulations! And Diversified Livestock, the state sponsor, is Associated Feeds. The three finalists are Tyler Dietz, Merced El Capitan FFA. Hannah Mancibo, Chowchilla FFA. And William Claflin, Redlands Grove FFA. And the state winner is Hannah Mancibo. Hannah is a senior at Chowchilla Union High School. Since she was 9 years old, she has bred, raised, shown, and sold boar goats, dairy goats, and dairy cattle. Hannah is attending Cal Poly San Luis Obispo in the fall to major in dairy sciences and minor in agriculture business. Congratulations! Environmental sciences and natural resources are our next proficiency area. The state sponsor is the California Farm Bureau Federation. The three finalists are Gary Molina, Winters FFA. And Lisa Wolf, Santa Elena FFA. This state winner is Lisa Wolf. Lisa is a sophomore at St. Helena High School. Lisa's SAE includes a maintenance and replacement of Sulphur Creek fish ladder. Her goal is to ensure a safe environment for local fish to travel upstream to spawn. Lisa plans to transfer her management skills into a future career in viticulture. Congratulations, Lisa! The state sponsor in equine science entrepreneurship is Triple Crown Nutrition Incorporated. The three finalists are Elise Guerrero from Merced Golden Valley FFA, Colby Perry from Toll House Sierra FFA, and Clayton Guy from Mountain Empire FFA. And the state winner is Colby Perry. Colby Perry is a junior at Sierra High School. He raises horses and Angus cattle. His equine project includes raising three horses, I'm a Bee, I'm a Believer, and Roger Rabbit. Colby shows at the NCHA weekend shows and ages events. Colby plans on going into the field of equine nutrition. Congratulations, Colby! The Equine Science Placement state sponsor is Elk Grove Milling Incorporated. The state finalists are Madison Machetto from Jackson Argonaut FFA, Eric Alperin from Gonzales FFA, and Cameron Horton from El Capitan FFA. And the state winner is Madison Machetto. Madison Machetto is a senior at Argonaut High School with an extensive placement project in equine sciences. Madison works for an elite Arabian horse training facility, managing horse health, training, and expedition. Madison's responsibilities have grown to make her executive decisions on horse health and training. Due to her work in this SAE, Madison gained recognition from her employer at a national level. Congratulations, Madison! The Food Science and Technology Proficiency is sponsored by the Ammon Board of California. The state winner is Samantha Rios. Samantha is a senior at Clovis East High School. For the past 3 years, she has participated in food science, making candied almonds in different flavors and selling them. Samantha is planning to pursue a career as a pediatrician. Congratulations, Samantha. The forage production proficiency is sponsored by David A. Mendonca Farms. The three finalists are Drew Vogt from the Reedley Emanuel FFA chapter, Steele Powell from Sutter FFA, and Cole Dexheimer from El Capitan FFA. And the state winner is Cole Dexheimer. Cole is a senior at El Capitan High School in Lakeside, California. Cole's SAE is a production of over 200 acres of dry land oat hay that is marketed to local ranches and feed stores. Cole plans to pursue a career as an agricultural engineer. Nice job, Cole! Crop Science, a division of Bayer, is a state sponsor in forest management and products. The finalists are Cameron Kempin from the Dixon FFA chapter, Daniela Martinez from Hamilton City FFA, and Nicholas Duff from Napomo FFA. And your state winner is Nicholas Duff. Nick Duff is from the Napomo FFA chapter in the South Coast region. Nick has worked at a local Christmas tree farm, helping customers select and fall live Christmas trees, as well as managing replacement trees. Nick plans to utilize his skills in forest management to pursue a pest control advisor certificate at Modesto Junior College in the fall before transferring to Cal Poly to major in environmental plant sciences. Congratulations, Nick! The next next proficiency area is goat production, and is sponsored by ShowRite Show Feeds. The finalists are Dominic Santaya from Altaville Bret Hart FFA, Danielle Hutchinson from Adair Liberty FFA, and Joshua Albrecht from Core Butte FFA. And our state winner is Joshua Albrecht. Josh is a junior at Core Butte Charter High School. His dairy goat SAE consists of breeding, raising, milking, and exhibiting 40 Nigerian dwarf, Toggenburg, and Alpine dairy goats. Josh plans on attending Colorado State University to pursue a degree in equine sciences. Congratulations, Josh! Grain production placement is sponsored by VA Farms Incorporated. The state finalists are Ethan Harlan from Woodland FFA, and Tyler Avila from Porterville FFA. The state winner is Ethan Harlan. Ethan is a senior at Woodland High School. Ethan's SAE consists of grain production placement at Harlan Family Ranch, where he manages rice and wheat production, performs equipment maintenance, and completes projects in the welding shop. Ethan plans on attending Oregon State University in the fall to pursue a degree in agriculture business and return to Woodland after college graduation to work on the family operation. Congratulations, Ethan! In the area of home and/or community development, the state sponsor is the Ammon Board of California. The finalists are McKenna Henley from Patterson FFA, Kevin Jess from San Luis Obispo FFA, and Dominique Renucci from Covina FFA. And the state winner is McKenna Henley. McKenna Henley is a student at Patterson High School. McKenna's SAE involved taking care of homes and remodeling them as needed. She plans to go to Modesto Junior College to study criminal justice and one day become a fish and game warden. Nice job, McKenna. The Southern Region CATA is a state sponsor of the Landscape Management Award area. The finalists are Kira Wright from Atwater FFA, Danny Hoya from Madera FFA, and Danielle Lopez from Julian FFA. And our state winner is Danny Hoya. Danny is a graduate of the Madera FFA chapter. For the past 5 years, Danny has worked for Hoya Landscaping Maintenance and transforming yards all over the Madera, Fresno, and Clovis areas. Danny currently serves in the National Guard. Congratulations, Danny! Nursery operations is the next proficiency area. The state sponsor is Gonzalez Young Farmers. The finalists are Jared Mandrell from Morgan Hill Sobrato FFA, Ashley Moby from La Habra FFA, and Irene Duran from Linden FFA. And the state winner is Ashley Mobley. Ashley is a fifth-year member of the La Habra FFA chapter and is a first-year student at Cal Poly Pomona, majoring in ag business. Ashley designs and sells succulent plants and designs to her businesses and her community, and has expanded her SAE by building a greenhouse at home to increase the varieties of plants she uses for her business. Ashley is pursuing a career related to agriculture business and hopes to explore her options with internships. Congratulations, Ashley! Yeah! Outdoor recreation is our next area. The state sponsor is the Ammon Board of California. The finalists are Ian Santoro from the Madera Liberty FFA chapter. Hunter Derrick from Hamilton City FFA. And Dylan Chi from Mount Empire FFA. And the state winner is Dylan Chia. Dylan is a graduate member of the Mountain Empire FFA. He is employed at a private hunting club where he works performing a variety of tasks. Dylan works closely with the members and their guests, maintains the health and nutrition of the mallard ducks, pheasants, chukars raised on the property. Dylan is attending community college and plans to transfer to Fresno State to pursue a degree in animal sciences. Congratulations, Dylan! In the area of pomology production, the state sponsor is Martinez Ranches Incorporated. The finalists are Josh Hubel of the Merced Golden Valley FFA chapter. Riley Neese of the Visalia Central Valley Christian chapter. And Jenna Moore of the Napomo FFA chapter. And the state winner is Riley Neese. Riley Neese is a junior at Central Valley Christian High School. For the past 3 years, her SAE involves working on her family's cherry tree orchards, where she manages fertilization, water, and general maintenance. Riley would like to utilize her knowledge base that she has developed towards a crop science major. Congratulations, Riley! Foster Farms is the state sponsor of the Poultry Production Proficiency Award. The list of finalists includes Luke Irvin from Gull FFA, Fiona Affronti from Healdsburg FFA, and William Claflin of the Redlands Grove FFA. And our state winner is Fiona Affronti. As a sophomore, Fiona has both a placement and entrepreneurship projects in the area of poultry production. She began as simply raising market chickens for her local fair and soon became highly interested in all things poultry. After her first fair, she began working at her school's tech for their laying hen enterprise. Additionally, she raises 20 market turkeys for a Thanksgiving project to sell to local community members. She hopes to continue her poultry projects and expand them each year in both size and scope. Congratulations! Sheep production is sponsored by KC Sheep. The three lucky finalists are Jeanette Gomes of Central Catholic FFA, Ashley Border of the Livermore FFA, and Lindsay DeGraff of the Marysville FFA. And your state winner is Lindsay DeGraff! Lindsay DeGraff is a junior at Marysville High School. Lindsay raises a flock of merino wool sheep and runs a ranch management business where she works on several local sheep farms, assisting in the daily care of the livestock. She hopes to attend Texas A&M where she will study animal sciences and hopefully compete on their wool judging team. Congratulations, Lindsay! Small animal production and care is sponsored by the state level by Cal Ag Jobs. The finalists are Roanne Perry of the Altaville Bret Hart chapter, Brenna Korovich of the Fresno Central FFA chapter, and Emily Hambly of the Healdsburg FFA chapter. And the state winner is Emily Hambly! Emily Hambly is a senior at Healdsburg High School. She has been raising market and breeding rabbits since she began with her market pen as a freshman. Utilizing her extra rabbits from that year, she has increased the size of her project to include breeding market rabbits for not only herself, but other local 4-H and FFA members. Her rabbits are incredibly are incredibly competitive at the local and county fairs, winning numerous championships. Nice work, Emily. Specialty animal production is sponsored at the state level by Steve and Victoria Gomes. The state finalists are Ashley Anderson from the Turlock FFA chapter. Bailey Alexander from the Foothill Balsiger FFA chapter. And Anna Grosky of the Mission Viejo FFA chapter. The state winner is Bailey Alexander. Bailey is a senior at Foothill High School in Palisadro outside of Redding, California. Bailey has worked at Wooten's Queens and Bees for the last 2 years, assisting in the office with paperwork, tracking invoices, and helping customers. Bailey also helps in the yard with moving over queen cells, feeding bees, putting out queen cells, and packaging boxes. Bailey is planning to major in agribusiness with a minor in viticulture at Fresno State University. Congratulations, Bailey! The Ammon Board of California is a state sponsor in the Specialty Crop Production Proficiency Award. The finalists are Sebastian Pinnon from the Santa Maria's Pioneer Valley chapter, and Renee Birchfield of the Escondido FFA chapter. And our state winner is Sebastian Pinnon. Sebastian is a junior member of the Pioneer Valley FFA. Sebastian's SAE focus was sustainable and culturally relevant production and grew a wide array of ornamental gourds and Indian corn from the community of Santa Maria. He was involved in nearly every aspect of specialty crop production, from land preparation and irrigation to harvesting and marketing. Sebastian is planning on expanding his specialty crop business in the future and pursues a career in agribusiness. Congratulations, Sebastian! Swine Production Entrepreneurship is sponsored by the California Pork Producers Association. The finalists are Paige Henry from the Galt FFA chapter, Olivia Valdez from the Clovis East FFA chapter, and Lydia Miramontes from the Wildemar Asinar chapter. The state winner is Olivia Valdez. Olivia is a junior at Clovis East High School. For the past 3 years, Olivia has worked on maintaining and producing high-quality genetics to produce show pigs. Olivia is planning on attending Purdue University and pursue a career as a produce broker. Congratulations, Olivia! High Noons Feed sponsors a swine production placement for efficiency. The list of the finalists include Alyssa Donich of the Ripon FFA chapter, Kimberly Holgan of the Visalia VTech FFA chapter, and Kaylee Gates of the Menifee Heritage FFA chapter. And now our state winner is Alyssa Donich. Alyssa is a junior at Ripon High School. For the past 3 years, Alyssa has worked at Triangle L Farms, a show pig operation, where she does the tasks of breeding, farrowing, cleaning, feeding, and monitoring animal health. The mentorship and experiences that Alyssa has received from the Luis family at the Triangle L Farms will be a great asset in her career goal of becoming an agriculture instructor. Congratulations, Alyssa! Turf Grass Management is sponsored by Crop Science, a division of Bayer. The finalists are Kira Wright from Atwater FFA, Jose Gutierrez Reyes from La Habra Sonora FFA. Our state winner is Kira Wright. Kira is a senior at Atwater High School, has been an FFA member all 4 years. Kira works for the family business, which her brother started in 2008, Wright's Lawn Care. Kira plans on working for the business full-time after graduation, hoping to grow the services and customer contracts. Congratulations, Kira! Tanimura & Antel Incorporated is the state sponsor of the Vegetable Production Proficiency. The finalists include Allison Basilma from the Merced Golden Valley FFA chapter. Alexis Batista from the St. Helena FFA chapter. And Zaya White from the Loyalton FFA chapter. And the state winner goes to Alexis Batista. Alexis is a senior at St. Helena High School and a member of the St. Helena FFA chapter and the North Coast region. For the past 3 years, Alexis has been planting, producing, processing, and selling high-quality pumpkins on a 3-acre farm, as well as growing a variety of different vegetables that are grown on a 22 garden beds on his high school campus. Alexis will be attending Chico State University this fall to major in agriculture science in the hopes of becoming an agriculture teacher. Great work, Alexis! Veterinary medicine is sponsored by the California Compaction Equipment Incorporated. The state finalists are Malia Ramos from the Sacramento Sheldon FFA chapter. Renee Rodriguez of the Bakersfield FFA chapter. And Laura Anderson of the Healdsburg FFA chapter. And the state winner is Malia Ramos. Malia is a senior at Sheldon High School. For the last 3 years, Malia has worked as a veterinary assistant at Hatton Veterinary Hospital. Malia plans on investing her earnings from this job to pursue a career in the medical field. Congratulations, Malia! Sun-Made Growers of California are the sponsors of the Viticulture Production Placement Proficiency Award. The three finalists are Chance Granley from the Lodi FFA chapter, Alexis Batista, the St. Helena FFA chapter, and Garrett Cook of the Foothill Balasidra FFA chapter. And our state winner is Garrett Cook. Garrett is a high school senior at Foothill High School in Palisadro outside of Redding, California. For the past 3 years, Garrett has worked in the vineyards and winery at Anselmo in Shingletown, California. Garrett is planning to continue working at Anselmo while attending the heavy equipment operator program at Shasta College. Congratulations, Garrett! Wildlife Management is sponsored by Prather Ranch. The finalists are Austin Blitch of Chowchilla FFA and Taylor Williams of Chico FFA. And the state winner is Taylor Williams. Taylor is a junior at Chico High School. For the past 3 years, Taylor has worked at Rancho Esquan, salvaging eggs, hatching, and caring for ducklings to then release them into the wild. Taylor is planning on using this knowledge she has gained to pursue a degree in natural resources with her career goals to work with fish and wildlife. Congratulations, Taylor!
Once again, let's put our hands together for our state proficiency finalists!
So you see, Kyler and I, we're both avid golfer dudes, because that's what guys like to do on the weekends, all right? So, because Saturdays are for the boys, we thought it only appropriate to put in a little bit of practice here on stage, right, Kyler?
That's absolutely right.
All right, what's your club of choice, my dude?
Obviously, it's a dude iron.
Makes sense. Let's dude it.
Okay. We'll be hitting out into the crowd some foam personally signed golf balls for each of you to enjoy.
Well, Kyler, I think I've had enough practice for today.
Me too.
But you know, you might consider Kyler and I talented golfer dudes, but Kyler,
who's more talented than us.
Our next state FFA talent.
Thank you.
You can kind of draw that one.
Good evening, guys. My name is Kaylee Akers, and I'm from the El Capitan FFA chapter in Merced.
The National Chapter Award Program recognizes FFA chapters that successfully complete an annual Program of Activities, POA, which includes a series of activities designed to encourage its members to grow as individuals, to work as a team, and to serve others.
The finalists are... from the San Joaquin region, Bakersfield North. From the North Coast region, Dixon. From the Central region, Galt Liberty Ranch. From the South Coast region, San Luis Obispo. And from the southern region, Norco. And the 2019 Chapter of the Year goes to San Luis Obispo! Representing the South Coast region, we have the San Luis Obispo Chapter. The San Luis Obispo prides themselves on encouraging students to become leaders through activities such as their veterinary science contest, an event supported by Dr. Melissa Greenberg, Farm Supply, and other local veterinarians and companies. By hosting an Ag Day, the SLO chapter has been able to inform elementary school students about different facets of the agriculture industry, such as floriculture and livestock handling. Additionally, San Luis Obispo promotes agriculture by conducting home visits in order to create a three-way connection between students, advisors, and parents. Congratulations, San Luis Obispo FFA!
Let's give a round of applause to all of our national chapter finalists.
Across California, there are chapter reporters that ensure both the story of their chapters and agriculture is communicated to the consumer. Please join me in welcoming to the stage our state star reporter finalists.
The 2019 Star Reporter finalists are from the Central Region, Elizabeth Watkins. From the North Coast Region, Josie Davidson. From the San Joaquin Region, Amanda Quinn. From the South Coast Region, Clarissa Rios. From the Southern Region, Melanie Lopez. And from the Superior Region, Samantha Downey. And the 2019 Star Reporter is Elizabeth Watkins from Modesto Central Catholic FFA. Representing the Central Region, we have Elizabeth Watkins from the Central Catholic Chapter in Modesto. Elizabeth utilizes Facebook, Instagram, and Snapchat in order to promote Central Catholic's five-year-old program. In addition to using these social media platforms, she has also submitted articles to New Horizons, the Modesto Bee, the View from Del Rio, and the Stanislaw Farm Bureau. Elizabeth has been reported on Fox 40, KNX, Off Farm Income, KATM, and KSTE. She believes that by promoting their chapter, Central Catholic will be able to attract new members to their program, as well as inform the public about the ongoings in their chapter. Nicely done, Elizabeth!
Once again, let's put our hands together for our state Star Reporter finalists!
The Website Development Award recognizes those FFA chapters that develop and maintain an effective chapter website. Each website submitted was scored on ease of accessibility, creativity, and content. This year, the websites were also scored based on their inclusion of the chapter's program of activities and a pictorial year in review. Based on the score they received, the CHOP chapters were invited to participate in an interview which occurred here at the State FFA Leadership Conference.
The 2019 State Website finalists are Merced, Westminster, Chowchilla, Holtville, Livingston, and St. Helena. The 2019 state winning program of activities go to Holtville!
the 2019 state-winning year in review is Livingston! And your overall 2019 state-winning website goes to St. Helena! The State Website Development Award recipient is St. Helena FFA. St. Helena FFA has crafted an easy-to-navigate website that provides any website visitor the information they need to understand the FFA and agricultural education. On the website, you have a chance to get to know the chapter officers, the agricultural advisors, and the agriculture courses available. Throughout the website, there are descriptions of each career development event and leadership development event offered at St. Helena. The website includes an extensive program of activities and calendar of events. St. Helena FFA explains the importance of SAEs, explains the types of SAEs, and also highlights outstanding SAEs within their chapter on their website as well. They have a special tab for member resources, ensuring that all members can find all the info they need regarding the program, applications, and activities with just a simple click. Congratulations, St. Helena FFA!
Let's give all of our web design finalists one more round of applause.
You know, Matt, one of the biggest parts of just us guys being dudes
and dudes being guys
is the fact that we love our mothers.
That's right. You know, Kyler, I love my mom so much, she tucked me in till I was 12.
I could tell. Now, I love my mother so much, I even wash underneath her car.
Wow. Kyler, you know what else I love, though?
What's that?
Our state FFA talent.
Everybody. Hi, guys. Like I said before, I'm Ashley Thornton from Adair Liberty in the San Juan King region. Just an FYI, my birthday's tomorrow, so if anyone wants to get me anything, like, hit me up. No, I'm just kidding. But for real, add me on Snapchat. Ashley11005. Like, hit me up, everybody. This is a serious song. I'm so sorry that I'm all excited.
What's left to say? These prayers ain't working anymore. Every word shot down in the flames. What's left to do with these broken pieces on the floor? I'm losing my voice, calling on you. 'Cause I've been shaking, I've been bending backwards till I'm broke. Watching all these dreams go up in smoke. Let beauty come out of ashes. Let beauty come out. Put out the fires in my soul.
'cause I need you here. Oh, 'cause I've been shaking, I've been bending backwards till I'm broke, watching all these dreams go up in smoke. Let beauty come out of ashes. Let beauty come out of ashes. And when I pray to God, all I ask is, can beauty come out of ashes?
Bachman.
And I'm Celeste Thompson, and we're Alexius's best friends. From the first time I met Alexius, I knew she was a natural born leader. Our first conversation was at our freshman orientation when I could have sworn she was a senior link crew leader. Finding myself a little confused when she didn't have the answers to my questions, but from that point on, I knew we would be best friends. Through the years, Alexius has taught me a few valuable lessons. Courage over comfort. Always put hairspray on your nylons so they don't tear. And dreams can come true. Alexius has the type of personality that everyone wants to be friends with. She can light up a room just by walking in. She's the type of person you want to tell all your secrets to. You can always count on her to give you the best advice and to put a smile on your face. Not only does she always put her heart and soul into everything she does, she strives to impact the lives and members through FFA. I am so proud we got to share her with you, California FFA. Though we missed her, we know that everyone needs a little Alexius in their lives.
When I met Alexius, it was at our first Parley Pro practice freshman year. I had two thoughts run across my mind. Wow, this girl's intimidating, and I wonder if she'll be my friend. My thoughts were just a little off because we became best friends. Shortly after that, she moved in with me and became my adopted sister. Living with her wasn't always easy, but the hard times helped us create an irreplaceable bond. We would stay up late, swapping stories, cracking jokes, our once-a-week confessions, and the occasional tears. I vividly remember our first state conference when she told me that she wanted to become a state officer. She had so much light and enthusiasm across her face. I saw that same reaction every single time she accomplished something. When she became a state officer, she told me that she wanted to impact the lives of others the same way that this organization has impacted her. I have absolutely no doubt that she has done exactly that. It is our honor to introduce our best friend and your state secretary, Alexius Wolf, with her retiring address, The Value Within.
Put your makeup on, get your nails done, curl your hair, run the extra mile, keep it slim so they like you. Do they like you? Get your sexy on, don't be shy, girl, take it off. This is what you want to belong, so they like you. Do you like you? You don't have to try so hard. You don't have to give it all away. You just have to get up, get up, get up, get up. You don't have to change.
About a month ago, I came across a video, and I thought I would share it with all of you today. This is a dollar bill. Seems pretty simple, right? Say I go into a store, and I want to buy something for 68 cents. Can I buy it with this dollar bill? Yeah, I can. Okay, now say I go into a store, and I want to buy something for 72 cents. And after tax, it winds up being 94 cents. Can I buy it with this dollar bill? Absolutely. Now, what if I crumple this dollar bill into a ball? Crumple it up. How much is it worth now? A dollar? But I crumpled it up. It must be worth 95 cents, right? It can't be worth a dollar if I crumple it. All right, how about it's crumpled, but now I'm going to stomp on it. So now it's crumpled. It's stomped on. How much is it worth now? Wait a minute. So you're telling me that even though I crumpled it up and I stomped on it, that it's still worth a dollar? Okay, how about it's crumpled, it's stomped on, but now I'm going to throw it in a trash can somewhere. So now it's in a trash can next to some old food, garbage, a whole bunch of nasty stuff. How much is that dollar bill worth now? So you mean to tell me that even though I crumpled it up, stomped on it, and threw it in the trash, that I can easily pick it up, wipe it off, unfold it, and it's still worth a dollar? I'm sure there are days we may feel like this dollar bill. We may feel crumpled up, pushed aside, and deep down, we may feel like we have lost our worth and value along the way. I am here to tell you today that this dollar bill doesn't lose its worth and value, and neither do you. There is nothing in this world that can take your value away from you. Our experiences shape us into who we are, but it is in those times where we must see the value within them. In life, we all experience obstacles, some maybe bigger than others, but it is in those times where we must see the value within the experience, and in turn, use that experience to invest into others. Personally, in my life, there have been a few obstacles. I have always grown up with very little and in a financially unstable family. My mom was always a single mother of four kids with no education. This meant my mom had to work several minimum wage jobs just to keep our family afloat. The thing is, when you grow up in poverty, you don't really know anything different. And poverty caused my family to move around quite a bit growing up. And right at the end of my seventh grade year, it seemed like my life slowly but surely started to turn upside down. It seemed like just a normal day, and then a repo man came to our door and proceeded to repossess my mom's vehicle because she no longer had enough money to pay the bills. Later that day, our landlord came to the door and proceeded to give us an eviction notice, letting us know we had 30 days to find a new home. My mom, Grandma, and I searched for what seemed like forever for a place for our family to go. But because we were unable to find our place, we found our way to Bakersfield. More specifically, we found ourselves at the Bakersfield homeless shelter. You see, if we wouldn't have found our way to the Bakersfield homeless shelter, we would have ended up on the streets, having nowhere to go. But the thing is, this was the third homeless shelter my family and I had lived in. But yet this one was so different. If we wouldn't have found our way, we would have ended up on the streets, having absolutely nothing. But as an eighth grader, I was ashamed and embarrassed. I was afraid of what others would think of me. Oftentimes, kids from my school would come and volunteer at the homeless shelter, and I did everything I could to stay away from them. Oftentimes, I would avoid coming into contact with anyone and everyone just so I wouldn't be judged. I simply felt like my family and I had lesser value compared to others because we didn't live in our own home. And we couldn't even afford food to feed ourselves. Just sharing this story today scares me half to death. But I know there is someone going through the same thing right now. I'm sure there are even more people going through something 10 times worse. And I realize it's hard to see your value through tough experiences. But I promise you that no matter what you are going through, you have value. You will be able to use this experience to add value to someone else's life. We all go through things. Some of them are hard. But there comes a time where we must accept where we have been and what we have been through and use that to influence and invest in others. Our experiences become a resource to invest in others. There have been countless members this year that have shown me the importance of seeing the value within our experiences and using it to invest in those around you. Let's take a step back to the beginning of this year. My team and I were at the San Joaquin Regional Boot Camp. And this is where I met the Bakersfield West Chapter Officer Team. You see, I didn't have much conversations with Bakersfield West the first day of boot camp. But then I realized that during reflections, they didn't have a facilitator to help lead them through reflections, so I took it upon myself to get to know them. When we first started, they were very reluctant to share, seeing as they didn't know their teammates very well, and the reflection question asked them to share personal information. This put me in an interesting predicament, but I figured the best way to make them feel comfortable was to share a piece of my story, even though the thought of doing that was kind of scary. I simply shared a small piece of my story. The first question was pretty simple. What do you value most? I simply shared experiences and challenges I had been through. And in turn, they felt comfortable enough to do the same thing. I showed a small sense of vulnerability and courage. I used my experiences to invest in those chapter officers. Looking back on that night with Bakersfield West FFA, they would have never shared if I wasn't willing to share a piece of my story. They shared so many experiences and stories that I would have never guessed based off of my initial introductions.
And I was so empowered by their situations. They simply believed that their experiences added value to their life. It was that night with the Bakersfield West chapter officer team that I realized it doesn't matter where you come from or what you do. It's all about how you can use your experiences to invest in those around you. To my team that I now call my family, thank you for being five of my best friends. Thank you for the late night scary movies and live chats we have shared. You five are five of the realest people I've ever met, and you are always unapologetically yourself. Thank you for showing me the value behind every experience this year. I love each and every one of you more than you will ever know, and I love you so, so much. California FFA, thank you. Thank you for opening your homes and hearts to me this year. Thank you for showing me the value behind every experience. A good friend of mine, Garrett Aranda, once said that memories are best shared with those who have impacted your life the most. I can quite honestly say that the members of California FFA have impacted me more than you will ever know. And all of you in this arena today have done the exact same thing. And I can't help but say thank you time and time again. Thank you for being my home this past year and for giving me an experience I will never forget. When I started out today, I used this dollar bill. If we think about it, we are all given a dollar bill in life. And we are simply given chances to invest it into others. Sometimes we may feel like that crumpled up dollar bill, and it may be hard to see the value within those tough experiences. But I am here to tell you today that those experiences, no matter how tough, can be used for good. Those experiences can be used to invest in others. Because at the end of the day, who you are and what you have been through makes you utterly priceless.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe, someday these will be the good old days. All the love you forget, these reckless nights you'll regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
I was thinking about the band, I was thinking about the fans. We were underground, loading merch in that 12-passenger van. In a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name in the star. Now look at where we at, still growing up. Still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I've become. Couldn't wait to get older. Couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Wish I didn't think I had the answers. Wish I didn't drink all of that glass first.
Wish I made it to homecoming. Got up the courage to ask her. Wish I would have gotten out of my show. Wish I put the bottle back on that shelf. Wish I wouldn't have worried about what other people thought and felt comfortable with myself. Rooftop open and the stars above. Moment frozen, sneaking out and falling in love. Me, you, and that futon. We just begun. On the grass dreaming, figuring out who I was. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Never thought we'd get old. Maybe we're still young. Maybe you always look back and think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments. Maybe I've been missing what it's about. Been scared of the future, thinking about the past while missing out on now. We've come so far, I guess I'm proud. And I ain't worried about the wrinkles around my smile. I got some scars, I've been around. I felt some pain, I've seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days.
You don't know what you got till it goes, till it's gone. You don't know what you got till it goes, till it's gone. I wish somebody would have told me, good old days, all the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you'll regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
Yeah. I stare at my reflection in the mirror. Why am I doing this to myself? Losing my mind on a tiny error. I nearly left the real me on the shelf. No, 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 no. Don't lose yours in the blur of the stars. Seeing is deceiving, dreaming is believing. It's okay not to be okay. Sometimes it's hard to follow your heart. Does that mean you're losing? Everybody's bruising. Just be true to who you are. I forgot what to do to fit the mold, yeah. The more I try, the less it's working.
Cookie. Jabba. Jennifer Lopez. Sour Patch Kid. Jack Jack. Alexis.
Alexia.
Alexia. Alexa. Wait, I mean Alexius. Just like your name, you are one of a kind. I mean, who else can eat ranch by the bucket? Be sent to the hospital multiple times in a short month and single-handedly win a volleyball game against 5 random park-goers. Only you can, and that is one of the many reasons why we love you. We also appreciate your ability to keep it real, while still always being there for us when we need you most. You are beautiful inside and out. We cannot ask for a better team diva. Without you, our team would be basically a fraternity. Including Devin. So thank you for the femininity you bring to the group. But honestly, we are constantly impressed by your natural talent to teach and to make students feel value and importance. Hence the reason we know you'll change people's lives as an ag teacher or wherever you will go. Just like you, you have changed our lives forever. And even if you're having a hard time today, oh my gosh. Big inside joke there. I was having a hard time today. Always remember to bring your game on, princess. Love, Devin, Kyle, Oren, Matt, and Kyler.
California FFA, your 2018-2019 State FFA Secretary, Alexius Wolf!
Well, you know, Kyler, it's been a great session. Just us guys being dudes on this fine Saturday.
And our just dudes being guys, right?
Bet.
Throughout this session, we got to highlight some of the main times where us guys have just been dudes. And we have found out that us guys love our mothers, we love our golf, and we hate the girls cooking.
However, in this fifth session of the 91st Annual California FFA State Leadership Conference, we have recognized our outstanding scholarship and proficiency winners.
We have also recognized our national chapter and star reporter finalists.
And of course, we have heard the empowering words of our State Secretary, Alexius Wolf, with her retiring address.
Throughout this session, we are able to
believe in agriculture.
Madam Secretary, do you have a record of any further business which should now be transacted?
I have none, Mr. President.
Does any member know of any new or unfinished business which should properly come before this session? We are about to adjourn the fifth general session of the 2019 California FFA State Leadership Conference. As we mingle with others, let us be diligent in labor, just in our dealings, courteous to everyone, and above all, honest and fair in the game of life. Fellow members and guests, join me in a salute to our flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I now declare this session adjourned.